So, in today's video, I will show you how to make droplets for your bottle or can or any other beverage using three methods. In the first one, we'll be building a geometry node setup from scratch. In the second, I will show you a free add-on that does the job. And in the third way, I will show you the best droplets add-on I know. So, let's begin. The first thing we need is actually a droplet itself. And the way I do this is by adding a cube. I'll just get a bigger view. You have to add a subdivision surface modifier, and then you have to add one loop cut here, because if you actually take a look at droplet, you'll notice that it's flat at the bottom and then it's like a squashed sphere indeed. So right now we have a jelly, and now we have something that looks like a droplet. So we'll have one droplet that will be a sphere. So we'll be just like a perfect circle almost. And this one we want to get a bit stretched and then scale this. Like that, cool. So that will be the first droplet. And we need like two or three different objects. So let's just do these real quick. This one will be something like that. So just, you know, slight variation. Cool. Maybe even. Cool. And let's stretch this little more. Nice. And the last one will be a spherical. So I'll get a sphere. I'll delete everything at the bottom. Great. Fill the gap. Add a subdivision surface and add a couple of faces at the bottom. Cool. I'll just get this and scale this on Z axis. That'll be cool. Yeah, exactly. Nice. So we have three different objects for our droplets. Let's bring them to the top. Great. I'll give a bit more subdivision. So we'll go with level 3. Should be fine. And now we have to add a solidify modifier. Let's see how thick it is. It's about right. So I'll just go with the next one and the last one. Now we have to apply solidify modifier everywhere. Select the inner part of our droplet, and we'll have to flip normals. So we have blue normals, both for the outer and inner. Blue normals means that these are pointing outwards and stuff. It's more technicality, but it's important in this case. We have selected the inner one, and now we have to go Option or Alt N flip, and now we have blue everywhere. Same thing for this second one. So let's just get here, Alt N flip, and the last one. A little bit more trickier, but yeah, we are here. Let's see if Shift N will do the job. Yeah, Shift N works as well. Great. So we have three different objects, and now we have to add them into collection called droplets. Perfect. Now let's go to the can, change this from whatever to geometry nodes editor. And now we have to build a geometry node setup. This will be exciting, I guess. So the first things first, distribute points on faces, as we need some, you know, points on our can to then instance these to the can. Before the geometry nodes era, this would be done with particle system, but since we have geonodes, then there's no point with messing with particle system, obviously, to join the geometry so we don't lose the initial can. Next thing, instance on points, points to points, and then can do something like that. Then we can plug this, yep, to geometry, and then geometry to geometry. Now we have to drag droplets here and instances to instance. Go to the can and then change the scale using the instance on points. Anyway, we'll be adding shortly the random value node. For now, we want to just focus on adding whatever to our can. So, nice bot. Let's make this much and change from random to Poisson disk and then slightly distance so we don't have many overlapping, and now we can crank up distance max. And as you see here, these are not rotated correctly. So to fix this, you have to plug rotation to rotation, and now it looks way better. Great, so next step is to get random value, plug, take these values as, I guess, the max and then minimum to something like that, or we can even go lower and see what happens. And now we have the variety of different sizes of droplets, which is amazing. Yep, exactly. We can go density max even higher, though it will probably make your viewport irresponsible. So keep that in mind. I'll keep something like 500, will be fine. We can hide the droplet collection. And now the next problem we encounter is that these droplets that are like on edges, these will never like point the right way. So we have to get rid of them. Basically, we have to add a vertex group. Let's call this, I don't know, no droplets. And now what we have to do is to click on group input, go to group, then click plus, and then we have to click this and get no droplets. Then plug input to selection and we have nothing. So that's because we have nothing in this vertex group. So I can select everything, then assign, and then just select where I don't want any droplets to appear. So this will be like these hard edges. So remove, probably here, remove. Yep, we can do the same here and probably somewhere in the bottom. So you can select this one, remove, and this one, remove. Cool. And we pretty much solved the problem. Last thing we have to do is to add some material. So material for droplets is very simple. We can just go with a, can go here, so we don't have to get like set material and stuff. We can just go with this one and just add a simple material, which will be plain white, transmission to 1, roughness to 0, specular to 1, and then just plug all of these, select all of these, Control L, link materials, and just see if that works. Yep, let's see if on the can it works. Yep, and now let's go and hit render and see how it looks like. Look better. It's a little bit too like dark, etc. And what we can do about this is to actually lower down the IOR to something like that. Looks much better already. And last thing we can do to even get more details or something is to go to the can material where you have the label and check on the internet for textures like leaking, and I will show you how these look like. Let's go to material preview. Let's disable droplets for a while. Roughness map that shows us, like, you know, with the leaking or something like that, where there is a water, some droplets and stuff. And I just plugged this to color ramp and set values like 0.1 and 0. Here should be 0.3, something like that. And then just make sure that this is, that there is a contrast. It's not like that. It's, so we'll have much more details. All right, so plug this back, add these droplets back and see how the render preview looks like. Plug this to roughness. All right, so yeah, that's how it looks like. And that's the first way of adding droplets in Blender. Second way is by using an add-on called Droplet Generator by Jepay. It has been once featured on this channel when I was doing the Starbucks tutorial. Let's hit append, and then you have to find the add-ons folder or wherever you have this file, and then just click, double click on Droplet Generator, go to Node Tree and Droplet Generator. Now you have to go to your can, then GeoNodes, hit this panel to get all these setups, and then hit Droplet Generator. And now you have the Droplet Generator added. So from here you can, you know, set density, size, all that stuff, subdivisions as well. And yep, that's how it looks like. So this one is very simple, but now we will take a look at Droplet Generator, which is paid add-on. I mean, another one. Here it is, add the droplets. And now we have so many more options to choose from. Obviously, most important for now is just scale and density. So we can crank this to some like 1500. And what's really cool about this add-on is that you have a custom change size of big droplets, of medium droplets, of small droplets separately. You can change proximity so that when this value change, also the distance between droplets when they disappear also changes. That's what proximity is in Blender. And my favorite thing about this add-on is long droplets. You can hit add long droplets, long on, and then using the long animate, you can, you know, animate some droplets. And you can also see how droplets that are on this path or trail just disappear when these droplets goes down. So that's really cool feature of this add-on. And let's just preview how it looks like. And I forgot to mention that both Droplet Generator add-on and the Droplet Generator, this free one, come with a nice shader that has limit ray depth and limit shadows, so you can, you know, have better control over your artworks. So that's it for today's video. I hope you're gonna rock your artworks with some nice droplets. And if you're looking to step up your 3D game, check our free 3D training. Link is in the description.